Episode number 29.
Live life so that you create good vibes.
The good vibes.
Live life so that you radiate good vibes.
The good vibes.
Live life so that you generate good vibes.
The good vibes.
Live life so as to emanate good vibes.
The good vibes.
Spread the message of your life with good vibes. With good vibes.
With good vibes. Welcome to the Good Vibes Podcast.
Welcome, 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 my friends, and welcome to episode number 29 of the Good Vibes Podcast. I'm your host Tushar, and today we're going to have another amazing episode. And this is the intro to the episode. Like you know, I've started telling you about my current life in the intro, and I'm going to give you an update about how the podcast is progressing and how the statistics are improving and how we are reaching out to more and more people by the day. So the total all-time downloads is 1,399. So there's just one download remaining, and I mean, that could be any one of you. And it's going to be so amazing when it crosses 1,400. And in another few weeks, it's going to cross 1,500, which is going to be a big milestone. Let's see the downloads per country. So there is United Arab Emirates in the house. There's Russia, India, Germany, Canada, United Kingdom. USA has 86 downloads, the highest in the count. And the second highest is India, my country, 51. I'm speaking from Bangalore, India. I'm in my PG right now in Yelahanka. I go to Srishti Institute of Art, Design and Technology. I'm a design student studying creative education. And a little bit about my life right now. Everything is going great. I had very good dinner, and I'm planning another podcast with this person named Inez, who's going to feature on the show sometime in the future. But she's an amazing person, and you'll get to know about her in a podcast later. So there is one podcast scheduled with her. And then the second thing is that the artwork of this podcast is being done by Aayush Ray Chaudhuri himself. So he's going to be an animator in the future, and he does these great comic strips. So I've got him to draw the artwork for this podcast on his own. So it's his artwork and it's his voice in the podcast. So it's going to be a lit scene over here. And this is a term used by many Srishti students, lit scene, like it's going to be amazing. So let's tune in to what Aayush has to say. And this was recorded over a year ago when we became friends in the foundation year, the first year, and we've become better friends, and we've become very good friends over this course, and we are trying to tackle such topics and open up the people and make even people who aren't that extroverted or who feel that they need to be with themselves feel comforted. That's what this podcast is trying to do. The title's name is called Introvertism. So Aayush is an introvert, and we try to decode his story. We try to decode what he does, and through him we're trying to show even the extroverts that this is how the life of an introvert is. This is how the life of someone who doesn't feel comfortable opening up with other people is. And yes, that's the podcast. And you can follow him on Instagram with the ID @AAYUSHRC. Aayush RC. That's a double A. You can follow my page on Instagram @your_local_podcast. My name is Tushar Shankar on Instagram. I recently created a Twitter account, a Tumblr account, and a Pinterest account. So the Twitter one isn't very active as of now, but I plan on making it more active by the day. I think the Twitter handle is @Tushar007. Tushar007. The Tumblr handle is again @your_local_podcast. And if you want to join my Facebook group, just search the Good Vibes Podcast, the one with the yellow logo. That's the Facebook group, and you can join it by sending me a request. And my father is the Adam of that group. Yeah, that's really cool. And he's going to accept your request, and you can be a part of that group. And I update posts from Instagram. The posts I post on Instagram are again reposted on the Facebook group, so you can check them out there too. So that's about it. That's the intro. I really hope you enjoy this podcast. And if you are an introvert, or if you consider yourself to be an introvert, I would like to hear your thoughts and feedback about what all we covered and what you felt we didn't cover, because we can't expect to know your story by this discussion. This discussion is just an opening point, but we really want to try to help out. We want to dive deeper. We want to know more about you. So reach out to us, reach out to Aayush, or reach out to me or Instagram. Direct message us on Instagram or Facebook, so that we can respond and we can improve ourselves. Maybe we can record another podcast and Aayush again talks about something that we didn't cover this time. So I hope, that was a pretty long intro. It's, I think, around 6 minutes now. So I'll tune you into the latest podcast, and I hope you enjoy it.
Hey, my friends, and welcome back to today's podcast. Today, we are here with Aayush Ray Chaudhuri, who is my course mate at my new college, Srishti Institute of Art and Design.
Art, design, and technology.
So, welcome, Aayush.
Hey, thanks, Tushar, for inviting me here.
Yes, it's a pleasure having you here. And I just met Aayush, and he's such a good person. I had, like, long conversations with him, and they were very satisfying conversations. And one of them was about introvertism.
True.
So today's topic is whether introvertism is a choice or a personality. And we have Aayush over here, who considers himself an introvert as of now. So Aayush, what do you think? Is it a choice or is it a personality? What has it been for you?
For me, it has always been a choice, because this incident occurred to me when I was in 11th in Pune.
Okay.
So I met new people. But I constantly felt that since these are new people and this is like my first year, I should not talk much because they are not my friends, since I do not know them.
Mm-hmm.
So I constantly had a feeling that whatever I'm saying, it's quite boring, and I did not want to hear their feedback somehow.
Okay.
I was afraid for the negative results.
Okay.
So that's why I decided to become an introvert, and I completely, you know, had a closed mind among my friends.
Okay.
So yeah, because of that, I was completely depressed.
Oh.
Yeah, and the people whom I talked to a very few people,
mm-hmm.
but among them, what I could do is, like, I could only talk to them through WhatsApp, because we were in different classes.
Yes, yes.
So, and the people who were in my class and who were my best friends, they were either shifted, mm-hmm. or demoted, or were parted by some teachers.
Okay. So it came up as a choice.
Yeah.
You felt it wasn't right for you to share your opinion to the world at that point.
Yeah.
And you ended up talking to yourself. That's what you told me.
That's true. Because I always thought that what people might think, whatever I say, like, I did not want to think that after I tell my story, I did not want them to think that I was a loser or something,
mm-hmm.
or a coward.
You didn't want to be judged.
Yeah, I did not want to be judged.
Okay.
And that's why I could only rely on myself, because I won't waste my time if I talk to myself.
Yes.
And I won't waste anyone else's time.
So you felt satisfied and valuable,
yeah,
to yourself.
Yeah, because I was also helping myself through the depression, and I was also helping other people.
So you, actually spoke to yourself, right?
Yeah, it's like speaking to the air or speaking to an imaginary friend.
Okay.
It's because you can visualize their expressions. Because
yes.
In reality, it may happen that the people you're speaking to, they are bored.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see through their expressions. But when you talk to yourself in a closed room, making sure that no one is able to hear you, you feel a certain kind of peace around you.
Mm-hmm.
And you can also imagine the expression of the person you want to speak.
Mm.
You may be a boy or a girl or a crush of yours.
Yeah.
So you can even, if you want, you can also confess your feelings and imagine that he, she is, you know, feeling happy about it.
Okay.
So that helps me, you know, get rid of the depression.
Okay. So it's about expressing yourself.
That's true.
So
and knowing about
you...
myself too.
Yes.
Yeah.
And about?
Knowing about myself.
Yeah.
Too.
So you get to know yourself. You get to express yourself. And if it's to yourself, whatever it is,
yes.
I mean, we have tons of thoughts.
True.
I mean, whatever it is, if you feel that you're acknowledged, you get to move on.
True.
Right?
Yes.
So this is for you, if you're, it's for you, it's for anybody actually, because we need to know what's the mindset, how does it work? Because we have a lot of misconceptions about introverts. What are some of them that you face? What are the misconceptions that are placed around introverts?
Like, people ask so many questions that why do you do this? You have people to talk to.
Hmm.
Why can't you, if you, I can understand that you don't want to share your feelings, why can't you just write a diary or something?
Hmm.
So my response would be that I don't want to write a diary because, like, first of all, you have to find a diary. Second, you have to make sure that it's completely empty. You can't just, you know, grab someone else's book, because since it's his or her property, if you're writing something very personal, he or she might read it.
Mm.
Second, there is like, you have a specific time for writing a diary. So I did not want to follow
you
that.
You found talking to yourself the same as writing a diary, right?
Almost.
So it's someone told you, they were actually telling you to express yourself somehow.
Yes.
Okay. And what are the misconceptions? Like, people think introverts don't talk at all. But
yeah,
that's not
people,
true, because you're
talking
to an audience now.
Exactly. People mostly think that introverts are weird because they just, people have a misconception that all the introverts are nerds.
Hmm.
They always keep on gaming and reading books and stuff.
Hmm.
That's not true at all.
So what do you say if someone goes and helps out an introvert by just talking and listening to them non-judgmentally?
Yeah.
Would that make the difference for that person?
Exactly. I just want the listeners to like respond. It may also happen that the people, you know, they choose introvertism because the audience are not responding to him and just keep on ignoring him or her.
Okay.
Yeah, and that's what demotivates the
person.
Yes,
that happens. That happens a lot. We can't ignore that it doesn't happen.
Exactly. Like, if you just don't want to speak, just say that, can we talk about this later or something, like at least 5 minutes or 10 minutes.
Mm.
Then you yourself understand that you have to change the person.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have to change the topic or something which makes it interesting and which spices it up. Because it's completely not the audience's fault.
Yes.
Yeah. So that's the thing which
leads
you
need some kind of response. You need something so that you can do better.
Yeah, so that we can understand, like, it's our fault. So that we can realize it.
Yes.
Yeah, because, I turned an introvert because I could not realize it properly. And that's what... Yeah, and that's what made me become an
introvert. So it was very recent. It was 11 times. That's like 2 years ago.
Yeah, 2 years ago.
Before that?
Before that, I was 50-50. I had like many friends. And since I was in Pune, I was in DAV. So since I was there for 8 years, I had many friends.
Mm.
But in this college, I was only for 2 years. So I could not make so many friends.
Okay.
So that's the only thing.
Okay. But after that, you get to know yourself better. That's what you told
That's
me.
That's true.
What are the effects of introvertism?
How
do you know yourself? Yeah, the positive effects.
Positive effects are like...
I mean, because everyone, sometime or the other, needs time to introspect.
Yeah, that's
and
true.
And you guys are amazing at it. Right? So,
yeah, that's true.
So, you need some part of... you need to learn something from an introvert, how to introspect. So, what do you do?
For what?
Introspecting in general.
In general, I just keep on talking to myself. I don't care who is around me, because I keep on speaking in such a language which the other people do not understand. Like, I'm a Bengali.
Mm.
So, like, if since most of the people speak Hindi,
and
I know that I'm not around a Bengali person, I speak Bengali. So, they are like, what the hell are you doing?
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm like, since you cannot, in my mind, like, I'm not, since you can't understand anything, I don't give a damn.
Okay. So now, if you're an extrovert, you get to understand how the mind of an introvert works. And if you're an introvert, can you relate to this? That's a question for you to answer. Anyway, but we're not going to get into whether it's right or wrong, whether, because things happen, life goes on. And it's not that you took a wrong decision. It's what you felt was best at that time. And we can't say that you did this. We can't judge what you did.
Basically, you're just opening up to yourself because you're the only good listener to yourself.
Yeah. So everyone needs one portal to express themselves.
That's true.
So the only difference I would come upon between introverts and extroverts is, like you said, an introvert is close to others but open to the self.
Yeah.
That's the only thing.
And not only that, it, you know, being an introvert also, you know, helps you, you bring out your vocal skills.
Okay.
Yeah. So I could not, yeah. So it helps me in public speaking, like if we are doing a skit or something.
Hmm.
So it helps me rehearse my lines. At least someone is listening to me. I feel like that.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. So that's the only, that's one part of reason why I, you know, talk to myself.
Awesome. Awesome. That's really nice. And we were on the point whether it is, we were not discussing whether it's right or wrong.
Yeah, because most of the people, they think it's wrong and that's why they're discouraged.
And they don't accept it. That causes like a big...
And they don't even feel like, you know, being approached. They feel like they just become invisible kind of a thing. Like, but there's a time like they want to be approached for something, but that time what he wanted was he did not want to be visible. So that becomes a reality, and that's where he keeps on regretting that why he did this.
Okay, okay.
So this becomes a wrong thing.
Okay.
So I just ask for a little bit of response. That's it.
So the best you can do to help out someone in such a situation, because there are a few factors which may lead to introvertism, but may not be the only factors for introvertism.
Yeah, and it's also because kind now, of your fault. Like, you're not opening up. You don't know the person you're talking to, like how he feels.
And is it like if you open up, the other person opens up? It's something, sometimes we wait for them to open up first.
That's true.
But if we open up first and we see the other person respond somehow. Because
somehow.
We have to open up enough times so that we find the right person who responds the right way.
Yes.
And then it clicks.
Then
you
it
have
clicks.
You have someone.
Yeah, there's a, right.
So that's how we covered introvertism. Interesting topic. We talked to someone who considered it a choice and not a personality. Let's see in the future if we get someone who considers it a personality. That'll be an interesting
Nowadays I'm really trying to open up because I'm finding so many friends. Like I found Tushar. Like he's such a considerate person.
Thank you.
Yeah, like he values every opinion I talk about. So that's what helps me open up even more.
Yes. So
thank you, Tushar.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Aayush. It's great having you here. And I'm sure it's going to be a great, great help for someone who needs to hear a voice like you.
Thank you so much, Tushar, for inviting me here.
Yes.
You have just helped me become an example. So that's like
because, thing you did. Because, see, there's going to be some other Aayush somewhere in the world.
That's true.
And if he listens to your message, he's going to get inspired by you. So the best you can do is help someone out.
That's true.
Don't ignore.
That's why we have social media too, right?
We have social media too, but we need the human interactions to work. We need the human interactions to work. We need to really, really connect. So they're not different. They're not magical creatures who don't talk. They're human beings.
They just need to give it a try sometime.
And
a little bit of patience.
Yeah, a little bit of patience. So I'm not promoting extrovertism. I'm not promoting anything over here. But if you feel you need to express yourself, if you feel the need to express yourself, just go for it. It's worth it. Because if it's not that person, just move on to the next one. You'll find the right person somewhere down the line because you started doing it. And and also, not just that, go and listen to someone with an open ear, with an open mind. Non-judgmentally. Listen to them completely. Listen to them carefully.
That's
right?
True.
That helps.
Yeah, and not only that. Like, since this happened to me when I was in 11th and 12th, I always had my previous friends, like, from 3rd standard to 10th standard. I used to talk to them because I knew them
Okay, very well. So you kept connect with them.
Yep.
So this introvertism is just another topic for about expressing yourself.
That's true.
So find different ways to express yourself. It's not a one size fits all.
Like even I had my friends like in a different school, so I could talk to them. But if you guys do not have such friends also, you can just talk to yourself. That's the best opinion according to me.
Yes, and don't consider it weird. He found it really helpful. He healed by it.
That's true.
It helped him so much. So don't underestimate the power of such things. And thanks for that conversation, Aayush.
Thank you so much, Tushar.
Really, really helpful. I'm sure my audience will find it beneficial and inspiring. That was today's podcast. We'll come up with more course mates in the future. We may have another podcast with Aayush sometime in the future. So watch out for that. Till then, take care and I'll meet you again next time. Woo, wasn't that a great podcast? And that was Aayush. He's a darling of a personality. I mean, you should meet him. And I'm sorry about the intro. The intro had this like loud, you could hear an echo, kind of echo in the intro. That was because I forgot to switch on my mic and the mic of my computer was recording the entire intro. And this won't happen again, of course. It may happen, but I'll try not to make such mistakes. Rookie mistakes. Sorry, once again. But the quality is very good with this mic. ATR2100. Yes. Getting to the point, I hope you really enjoyed this podcast. And if you enjoyed it, I suggest or I like really request you to go ahead and rate and review this. Because that's the way it's going to grow and we're going to reach out to more people. We are a team. You listening to me and me speaking to you, we are a team. This is not my podcast. This is our podcast. So share it with a family member. Share it with a friend. Share it with someone who might relate to this topic or who might need this information to help someone else. Let's make this world a better place by one person at a time. So the other thing I wanted to talk about is if you want to sponsor me or if you want to be a patron for me, my Patreon page is opening up. There is still a little work left to do. So by the next podcast, it should be up and ready and the links will be sent to you in the description. Till then, if you have any good products, if you're into the world of podcasting, I would love to collaborate. So if you're listening to me and you're a podcaster and you have similar ideas and you feel we can gel together on this podcast, email me. My email address is tushartheevolvedlearner@gmail.com. That is TUSHARR the evolved EVOLVED LEARNER@gmail.com. And I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day ahead. See you until next time.
Spread the message of your life with good vibes. With good